Before this video starts, guys, go ahead and check out my side of the story. A video that I posted earlier, so go ahead and check it out. And seeing that I now know that I am not going to get copyrighted for posting fanfictions, this is a fanfiction, and the author is FG7Dragon. Go ahead and check him out. I'm going to be posting his link down into the description. The story name is Naruto, the Chaos Mage. It's roughly 300,000 words. And the fast readers, please don't spoil it for those who want to hear it from my side. So yeah, go ahead and enjoy though. And thank you for your support. So guys, I'm going to be giving you part 21 of What If Naruto Had Multiple People Sealed Inside of Him. So yeah, remember to get this one to 100 likes as usual. Share this to all of your friends in your social media platform. And enjoy, guys. So yeah, without further ado, let's begin this story. Start the intro. So, to do a bit of recap from the last part we left off, Naruto and his group along with Jiraiya was on the road as they were searching for Tsunade, as Asuna mentally informed Naruto that Kisame and Itachi are looking for them and hunting Naruto down, as Naruto told group about this as they planned for Kisame and Itachi. As Kisame and Itachi arrive at the door, as Naruto play a trick on them by transforming into Hashirama, and Neji transforming into Tobirama, as they then break the spell that they cast, and they start to fight as Eva and Neji took on Kisame and Naruto took on Itachi, as Naruto placed Itachi under the Tsukuyomi. As Itachi couldn't believe it, Naruto really has the Eternal Mangekyo Sharingan, and his is a lot powerful, seeing that his Tsukuyomi do not have a time limit. Itachi told Naruto everything, and Naruto also went through his mind, as Naruto told Itachi about his mother Mikoto, that he can bring her back, and Itachi was happy to hear that. After breaking the Tsukuyomi, Itachi informed Naruto where Zetsu is, as Naruto pulled out his sword and threw around the Hyorishin kunais as he vanished, and stabbed Zetsu right through the head with his chakra cancer sword, as Zetsu collapsed as Naruto defeat him and suck him right inside of his mindscape. As Naruto will search his mind later and get every information that Zetsu know. As Neji and Eva came back with Kisame, both his hands and his legs were cut off, but he was still alive as Naruto sucked him inside his mindscape as well. And with that, Itachi returned back to the Akatsuki after saying farewell, as he told the Akatsuki that Naruto is powerful, very powerful indeed, and he defeated Kisame and he had to retreat, as the Akatsuki believed him, as the masked man know that Naruto is getting stronger and stronger. As Naruto then find back Itachi, as Naruto was going to help him with his eyes, as Itachi was afraid of a needle. So yeah guys, that was basically the last part we left off. You guys can switch across the place and check it out for yourself. So, let's begin this new episode, shall we? You said it wouldn't hurt, said Itachi, as he rubbed his eyes after Naruto injected him with the needle. I said I will dull the pain of the injection, Naruto said. You didn't think that gaining the Eternal Mangekyo Sharingan would be painless, did you? The Eternal Mangekyo Sharingan? How? Itachi asked. I used some blood from your brother in the mixture. The tricky part was to make your Eternal Mangekyo look the same as your normal Mangekyo, so you won't get unwanted attention, Naruto explained. As for the pain, I feel the same thing when I get a new bloodline, so you shouldn't complain so much. Whoa, Itachi said as he blinked. So, what should I do now? Itachi asked. About the Akatsuki? Naruto said. Nothing at all. You will stay a member until after you become Konan's partner. Maybe you can get some information on her and Pain, but be subtle though. Let a few weeks pass before you attempt anything personal, any personal conversation. Start by stating the obvious, like her closeness to Pain. If nothing work, ask her how someone like her got involved with Madara. If she gets suspicious, point out that you're related to the guy by your eyes. Do you want me to get her life story or something? Itachi asks as he raises the eyebrow. Exactly, said Naruto. By the way, are you attracted to her? Naruto asks. No, she's definitely not my type. If that's what you're asking, Itachi said, confused. Good, an attempt to seduce her wouldn't work. And she would be pissed when you betray them, Naruto said. Me trying to be friendly is a bit out of character, Itachi said. Then don't be. If she asks, tell her it's because you spend so much time with insane idiots and she look pretty normal. Fine, I will contact you once a week, or when I find out something important. Rather, like who the new members are, Itachi said. Alright, see ya, Naruto said, as he sink into his shadow. A few miles away, Naruto emerged from Eva's shadow. Is it done? Negi asks. Yeah, I healed him up, and he will spend the next few months traveling with Kakazu, then Sasori, and then his partner will be Konan, Naruto said with a smirk. Joy, said Jiraiya as he rolled his eyes. Now let's go. One of Orochimaru's minor hideouts is nearby. As they all went off. So, how do we do this? Jiraiya asked, as they were out of the range of the hideout. We? You're just here because Naruto is here. You will be staying out here with Chisame and Kazumi, who will be scanning the hideout and give us real-time information, Negi said. Me, Eva, Negi and Chao will infiltrate the hideout and capture everyone and restrain them and bring them here one by one. This is a stealth operation. After everyone is tied up, Eva will use one of her spells and pack up the entire hideout, said Naruto. She can do that? Jiraiya asks. There's nothing I can't do, said Eva with a smirk. You can't swim, said Negi. Yeah, I've been teaching her for a while, said Naruto. And she still doesn't get it, Negi said. I will probably get a new bloodline from Kisame, so she might be able to breathe underwater, Naruto said. Enough talking, let's go, Chao said, as all four of them sink into the shadows. It only took about an hour to capture everyone on base, since it was more of a research facility more than anything. In the end, Eva transported the base into a glass dome in the palm of her hand. That was impressive, said Jiraiya in awe. It is also classified. You will never speak of it again, said Eva, as she placed a spear in a pocket dimension. Just one thing left to do, Naruto said, as he opened a black scroll, and take out a vial of blood. It was rather hard to get Mikoto's blood, considering that there was no body left. I actually had to fabricate it from some dry blood that she left behind. Good thing I moved her away from Fukaku before I tried to save her. Or the blood that would have been left would have been mixed with his, as he then poured the blood on a scroll. He then took the sacrifice, a female assistant who had a habit of killing some of the people she experimented on just because she could. He then slammed both of his hands on the scroll as he poured chakra into it, as the kanji for Edo Tensei formed out of the blood. As Naruto then went through hand sign as he slammed his hand on the ground, as the dirt under the woman rose up and covered her, as she took the form of Mikoto Uchiha. Before she could even open her eyes, Naruto placed the kunai in the back of her head, as he then slammed his hand on her stomach, using his magic cancel to dispel the jutsu. The part of her soul that inhabit the puppet body then flow right into Naruto's body, giving him the full access of her soul. Done, Naruto said. Are you okay? Eva asks. I'll be fine. I just feel a bit dirty using this jutsu, Naruto said. At least you're using an enemy as a sacrifice, instead of using one of your own followers like the snake, said Jiraiya. It's not that. I just feel like I disturbed the dead, said Naruto as he sighed. That is why you do it all so quickly, Eva said. In my opinion, you're doing her a favor. I doubt that it is healthy to be half on this side and half on the other. I totally agree, said Kushina in Naruto's mind. Thanks, said Naruto with a smile. Well, we should be going. Tell us when you find Tsunade, said Neji, as Shadow developed under him and went over to Eva and sucked in all of the prisoners. See ya, said Eva, as she and Neji and the prisoners vanished. Sometime later, I believe we're right on her trail, said Naruto. Geez, what give it away, said Jiraiya, as he looked at a massive hole through a wall and about 3 safe bottles. Silly old pervert, said Chao as she chuckled. You have no idea how many beans can cause this level of destruction, do you? Yeah, I know a lot of people can do it. But look at those safe bottles. That has to be Tsunade. Hey, I found her, said Kazumi as she arrived. She's at a nearby bar and she's not alone. It's her apprentice and her pet, Jiraiya asks. No, there's a third person, said Chisame. Oh boy, I didn't see that one coming, said Naruto. About half an hour later, the group walked into the bar. Tsunade, I found you, said Jiraiya. Jiraiya, what are you doing here? Tsunade asked in shock. Looking for you, actually, said Jiraiya as he took a seat in front of the tree. As he was quickly followed by Naruto, Chao, Kazumi, and Chisame. Before anyone could continue the conversation, Naruto ordered 5 bottles of sake as everyone raised their eyebrow. Old enough to kill, old enough to drink, he said. So Tsunade, what have you been up to? Asked Jiraiya. You know, this and that, she said. Have you seen Orochimaru lately? He said, getting straight to the point. Well, yeah, he came to talk to me earlier. He also told me about the invasion. Failed invasion, to be more precise, said Naruto with a chuckle, as he emptied the bottle of sake. Yes, he called it a minor setback, said Tsunade. So, how are his arms and his legs? Still missing? Naruto asked. He was using prosthetic limbs, actually, said Shizune. Did he now? I guess Sasori rubbed off on him a little bit. Well, desperate time called for desperate measures. Did he tell you how he lost them, by the way? Naruto asked. He said he lost them while trying to kill Sensei, said Tsunade. Ha! Huh. Pay up, Jiraiya! I told you he wouldn't admit it, said Naruto. Meh, I'll cover your drinks here. That should be enough, Jiraiya responded. Okay, that's cool with me, said Naruto. Hey, waiter! Another round of drink. Hey, wait just a minute here, said Jiraiya. Save it, old pervert. You walk right into that one, said Chisame with a smirk, as she poured herself another cup. What didn't the snake bastard admit? Asked Tsunade. That the brat here took away his arms and his legs, Jiraiya said with a smirk. You're kidding, right? The third woman at the table finally spoke up. Nope, I sent his own jutsu back at him, amplified at another level. It was sad, really, to see a former Hokage candidate lose so easily. Too bad that worm Kabuto helped him escape, though. Kabuto? The silver-haired guy with the glasses? Tsunade asks. Yeah, that same one, said Naruto with a nod. He may look weak, but he's near to Kakashi's level and has an incredible amount of knowledge in medical ninjutsu. Being Orochimaru's right-hand man has his perks, huh? As Naruto saw the third woman at the table, as her eyebrow twitched hearing Kakashi's name, as he looked at the woman curiously. So, I doubt you're here to just chat with me and remember the good days. Why are you here, Jiraiya? Tsunade asks. He is going to make you an offer you cannot refuse, Kazumi said with a smirk. Will he now? Said Tsunade. Yeah, Jiraiya said as he coughed. Tsunade, Sensei has named you his successor, and he wants you to become the 5th Hokage, Jiraiya said, as everyone rolled their eyes. So dramatic. I refuse. Only an idiot would want that job, she said. Pause, said Naruto loudly, drawing everyone's eyes on him. Let's rewind with what comes with you being the 5th Hokage, Naruto said. Like a short lifespan, Tsunade asked. Hey, it comes with being a ninja as well, Naruto said. So, if I'm getting this right, you're trying to bribe me to become the next Hokage, Tsunade asked. If you want to put it bluntly, yes, Naruto said, but I would prefer to call it persuasion. You won't lose anything if you listen to the offer, Jiraiya said. Fine, talk, said Tsunade. Well, for starters, you can start that medical program that you always wanted. After all, the only reason why it was rejected at first, it was because of the war. True, said Snati. Also, your entire gambling debt will get paid. You're lying, Snati said. I am being completely honest, actually, Narka said with a smirk. And I can give you a few other things that you always wanted. Such as? The Mokiton, Narka said. Turns out that Danzo has been doing some deals with Orochimaru. One of them was a new right arm that Danzo possessed, with the DNA of Hoshirama Senju and 11 Sharingan on it. My clan can safely extract the Mokiton genes from it and transfer that into you. As Naruto smirked, that's impossible. It's unheard of, said Snati. It has been done before, said Naruto, as he flashed his Byakugan and then his Sharingan. You stole? Said Snati. He stole nothing, Jiraiya cut her off. His bloodline allow him to gain another person's bloodline when he drink a certain mixture containing that person's blood. He has some very tight restriction on him in what bloodline he may gain. And the one that he has now, well, the two of them. He had his right to gain them. So you want the Mokiton in return for the offers you're making me, Snati asks. Nope, said Naruto, surprising her. If I want it, I could have taken it. But I already can control plants to a certain extent. Since I have a high affinity for both water and earth. And a master chakra control, so I can use Mokiton Jutsu anyway. The bloodline would just make it easier. So you would refuse if you were offered the Mokiton bloodline, Shizune asks. Refuse? No. But me getting the Mokiton has nothing to do with this negotiation, Naruto explained. Fine, let's say I trust your word on it. What else do you have to offer? Snati asks. Eternal youth, Naruto said. Huh, very funny, she said, rolling her eyes. Actually, I'm quite serious, Naruto said, as he picked up his drink, which was now red as he took a sip. You're making fun of me, aren't you? Said Snati, as she was getting annoyed. He's telling the truth, Snati. It was quite a discovery for him as well when he realized the result of mixing his bloodline with one of his remarkable original jutsus, Jiraiya said. Original jutsus? Shizune asked. As there was a poof as Naruto was surrounded by smoke. When he came out of the smoke, he was an exact copy of Snati. As Snati glared at him. Copperfield, said Naruto, as he looked down at his breath that he now has. As Shizune glared at him. What? She said. Just do it, said Naruto. Why? I'm just proving something. As she reached forward. What the hell? They're real? She said. Not exactly. That was merely the jutsu I came up with. It formed a physical shell of chakra around the user, making him an exact copy of the person or the objects he is impersonating, Naruto said. As there was a poof. As he returned back to normal, the bloodline I combine it with allow the user to transform into anything as he turned his arm into a blade. Now, the bloodline alone will make you receive eternal youth, but in order to maintain the transformation, you need constant focus. But by crossing it with the jutsu and tweaking it here and there, I have complete control, said Naruto, as he turned his arm into a sword and then back to normal. Unbelievable, Snati whispered. We can control time and space to a certain extent as well. But those are clan secrets, Chao said with a smirk, as no one bothered said anything. That's quite an offer you're making me there, but there is some reason I cannot return that you guys are not aware of, said Snati. Well, the entire civilian council has been found dead in Root HQ, cut into pieces, and also in a pool of their own urine. I killed Danzo myself and the two elders are to be executed for treason. There won't be another civilian council and no one will force you to try and repopulate the Senju and dishonor your deceased boyfriend Dan, though I personally believe he would want you to move on and be happy. Now I will ask you again, will you be our fifth Hokage? Naruto asks. As she looked down, not knowing what to say. Is it about Orochimaru's offer for healing his lost limbs? Asked Naruto, How do you know about that? Tsunade asked. Why else would he search for you? Naruto said. So what did he offer you? Wait, don't tell me. As he stood up from the table and went to a clear space beside Tsunade, there he transformed into Orochimaru with a prosthetic leg and arm. Tsunade, he said, in Orochimaru's voice, I am offering to bring your brother and your beloved back to life with a forbidden technique that I created. As Naruto then poofed back and returned back to normal. So, was that what he offered? Naruto asked. As Tsunade nodded, I knew it. I knew the bastard would try to pull something like that. Let me guess, he then used your fear of blood against you. Yes, said Tsunade as he closed her eyes. But that doesn't explain how you knew, or how you can impersonate him so well. It's a village secret, I am afraid. Only the Hokage, the Ninja Council, and a few others know it. I see, said Tsunade. The jutsu he think that he developed was a jutsu created by your uncle, the second Hokage. It's called the Edo Tensei. Tsunade's face was shocked after she heard the name of the jutsu. Yes, the one where the human sacrifice is covered in dirt and take the face and the shape of the person that is resurrected. And the soul of the summoned person is placed into the vessel. And Orochimaru can control them like a mindless puppet, Naruto said. No one said anything for 3 minutes as the information set into the mind of the three women in front of them. How do you know so much details? Said Tsunade. There is actually 2 places that jutsu is recording in, and I doubt that both of them are accessible to you. You mean one of your clan scrolls that at the Senju compound, or the Forbidden Scroll? Naruto asked. To be honest, I had the Forbidden Scroll in my possession after I graduated the academy, and I even copied a few jutsu from it, but Edo Tensei wasn't among them. I learned it the same way I got all that information on Orochimaru, which is a village secret. As for your compound, I've never been there, but you must have placed it under a blood and chakra seal when you left, right? Yes, I knew my blood could be acquired from the hospital, so I added a protection seal that only my chakra can release, said Tsunade. Why exactly do you have the Forbidden Scroll in your possession? Shizune asked. I was under orders from the Hokage to expose a traitor who wanted to steal it. Just who are you, kid? You have high class village secrets. You have access to the Forbidden Scroll. Hell, you even cripple Orochimaru, of all people. The third woman asks. Oh, that's right, we haven't introduced ourselves yet, said Kazumi, as she chuckled. Though, you should at least recognize your sensei's son, said Chao. You mean he's... The third woman eyes went wide. I am Naruto Uzumaki Namikaze Fuhin, the son of Minato Namikaze, and Kushina Uzumaki. I am also the founder and leader of the Fuhin clan of Konoha, and I am also the Jinjuriki of the Kyuubi, the Nine-Tailed Fox. It's a pleasure to finally meet you, Ren Inuzaka, said Naruto with a smirk. You know who I am? Ren asked. Obviously, said Tsunade as she rolled her eyes. Kakashi speaks rather highly of you, said Naruto with a smirk. He does? Ren asked as she blinked. Wait, doesn't Konoha consider her dead? Asked Shizune. They do, but that connection she has with Kakashi says different. Naruto's smirk grew even more as Ren's eyes widened. How did you know that? She asked. I had to heal his Sharingan. It has been damaging in his coils since he overused it as time. So I fixed it so he could deactivate it and reactivate it. How did you do that? Shizune asked. I just had to repair his coils, said Naruto. That's a very sensitive operation. It will take an average medic name about 6 hours to pull it off, said Tsunade. Yes, but they don't have yokai at their disposal, do they? Said Naruto as he raised the eyebrow. You use yokai in your medical procedure? Are you out of your mind? Tsunade yelled. Oh, don't bite my head off. It's not pure yokai. It's diluted with chakra. Seeing that if I use a drop of pure yokai, Kakashi, head will probably explode. Oh, I see your point, said Tsunade. So, are you going to be the fifth Hokage or not? He asks.
I am considering it, she said. As Naruto turned his head as he looked at Rin. What is it? She asked. You've been hiding all this time, said Naruto. I have, she said. But a look on her face, saying that she didn't want to talk about that right now, as Naruto dropped the subject. Tsunade then spoke. Tell me more about the Edo Tensei. It seems that you're disgusted by the jutsu, but it seems like you used it before, she said. Alright, what I'm about to tell you, you cannot repeat to anyone without Jiji or my permission, said Naruto. As Tsunade nodded, as Naruto told her about Mikoto, and that half of her soul was sealed inside of him, and he used the Edo Tensei to get her other half of her soul. He also told her about his mother, and tell them that he can release them when he create a new body for them, as they were surprised by these answers. Alright, enough talking, said Tsunade. Now, show me how strong you are. Show me that you were the one that defeated Orochimaru so badly. Fight me. As Naruto smiled. A few minutes later, Naruto and Tsunade were standing outside of the Tazuka town, a dozen feet away from each other, with the others a safe distance away. Tell me, brat, are you a genin like the other girls? Tsunade asked. Not anymore. I am a jonin right now, he said with a smirk. Good, then I won't hold back. As Tsunade thrust forward with amazing speed, as Naruto was surprised at her speed, as Tsunade was rushing towards him with her in-hand punch, as Tsunade eyes widened as he did something unexpected, he slammed his forehead right into the attack. As he used his chakra cancel and all of the power behind the punch vanished. As he then punched Tsunade in her arms and her legs, as he used his chakra cancel, making her chakra coils empty. As Tsunade was sent flying back when he delivered a punch to her stomach, as she flipped in the air and landed, realized that she could no longer use her chakra as Naruto emptied all of her chakra coils. In an instant he was in front of her, with his hand turned into a blade at her throat. So, do you surrender? He asked. As Tsunade smirked, fine, you win, she said, accepting defeat. As the others arrived, Shizune eyes wide in fear. Tsunade, are you alright? Your neck is bleeding. Seeing that a single touch from Naruto's sword made her neck bleed. Fine, she said, as she touched her neck and then looked at her hand. It's just a scratch. As she then blinked a few times. Hold on, how come her hemophobia isn't acting up? Rin asked, surprised. She was a trembling mess when Orochimaru bit his finger earlier. Well, after we drank blood the entire time we were at that bar, she should have gotten used to it, said Chizumi. Drink? Said Shizune as she took a few steps back away from them. Well, not real blood actually. One of our bloodlines allow us to create anything from chakra, food included. And since our main bloodline allows us to drink blood, we decide to drink it some of the time to get over the creepiness of it, said Naruto. No wonder that smell seemed very familiar, said Tsunade. Well, I guess I subconsciously acknowledge that blood isn't a threat after being near it for so long, she said. So, what's your answer? Asked Jiraiya. Alright, fine. I'll be the damn Hokage. To be honest, I missed the village a bit. After all, it wasn't the village itself that took Dan and Nowaki away from me. It was a war. Actually, said Naruto as he hesitated. What? She asked. About your brother. What about Nowaki? She asked. It wasn't. A stone shinobi that killed your brother. It was Orochimaru, Naruto said as he sighed. What? Tsunade yelled. Why? Asked Jiraiya. He only gained the access to the first Hokage's DNA after the war. He would have kept the necklace as well, but he was seen standing over the body. So he did the best thing he could think of in the situation so he wouldn't get caught. He reported the death of the first Hokage's grandson. That bastard, Tsunade said. When will he come for your answer? Naruto asked. In a week. I can't wait, she said. But guys, and the end this episode right here. If you want to see the next part of this, you already know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification to stay posted. And I hope you guys enjoy. But for now, I'm out of here and stay in tune. Peace. I think the girls with their nails done now.
Ha ha ha!